From the Barbershop, what the souvenirs tell us. Every right-thinking Edwardian traveller had to bring home souvenirs. On Titanic, they were sold at the barbershop. Here's the first-class barbershop aboard Olympic, full of wonderful things for the Edwardian traveller to buy. Here are a few of the things that you might have bought at Titanic's barbershop. Some of these were actually refound during the past few years, and maybe you can find one too. The roof of the barbershop fluttered with pennants, like this repro from the Titanic Historical Society, and under them hung big dolls and animals of all sorts for privileged children. Big Palmer Cox brownie dolls, felt dolls from Germany, like this Struwwelpeter doll, sailor dolls, Steiff dog puppets, Steiff bears, and Steiff cats. These were all expensive toys. And aren't they wonderful? I love that cat. The cat helps to date the picture, by the way. That cat stopped being manufactured in 1913, so this picture of the Olympic barbershop is probably pretty contemporaneous with Titanic. It's interesting that the souvenirs are in the barbershop. Only men went there, of course, and the White Star Line must be assuming that men spent most of the money. There are certainly a lot of boy toys. Pigskin wallets, Camoys pipes from London, the finest briar pipes ever made, classics and still being made. Pocket knives from F. Morden of Sheffield. Here's a simple one, actually from F. Morden, but they came in mother of pearl and silver and staghorn. That nasty hook at the left is a hoof pick. The barbershop sold the most modern type of pen, a fountain pen. An identical pen to this was actually recovered from Titanic. It sold pocket watches, of course, Swiss made. And Olympic, at least, sold wristwatches. This was unusual. Most men didn't wear wristwatches until the First World War. But some ultramodern, well-off men and women were having their pocket watches made into wristwatches like these, and at least around 1913, Olympic is selling them. Another favorite souvenir was something in silver plate, like this little loving cup. But of course it's what used to be the cheap stuff that really thrills us, because it has the name of the ship on it, the ship's pins, the cheaper knives with Olympic on them, the cufflinks, the cards, the kitschy lifesaver souvenirs. This pin cushion was actually built aboard Titanic. It's in the Branson, Missouri exhibit now. The souvenir teaspoons, the matchbox, the White Star Line match fab, the White Star Line buttons made into hat pins, one of the few things in the barbershop that was clearly meant for women. There are no pictures of the second-class barbershop in Olympic or Titanic. It would certainly have had more modest souvenirs. Hat tallies to go around a little boy or girl's sailor cap, tin ship buttons, or buttons begged from a steward. All too soon these would be not souvenirs of a voyage, but memorials of a wreck. But if you happen to find one or a picture of one or see one in an exhibit, think of what it meant first to the person who saw it, what you would have seen as you looked round the barbershop. The very grandest toy, something rich and modern and new, from a perfect voyage, to be remembered and to bring home to someone you loved. Thanks for watching from Sarah Smith and Crimes and Survivors.